We know they are, and I forget which, you know, when you get some emotional experience in a man, the right amygdala lights up, and the woman, the left. Why? And, you know, there's more connections between two sides of the brain in women than men. Women, for this reason, use both sides of the brain more than right-handed men, so they recover from strokes better than right-handed men. And we know in testing things that men do a little better in mathematics, women do better in verbal things. Our IQs of men, boys and girls are both 100 because they've adjusted the tests so that the strengths of women are countered by strengths in boys, and it comes the same. What they didn't do is equalize for the developmental age. Since boys develop slower than girls, if a boy has the same IQ at 12, as a girl does at 12, at 25 he'll probably have a higher IQ. And only by a couple points. But I'm glad I belong to the sex which has a higher IQ. But it doesn't mean much. It compensates, you know, for the fact that I'm not Chinese.
How important do you think it is in terms of women dropping out of the hierarchy at a fairly early stage in science and academia?
I think most people sort of say men are sort of more naturally seek dominance over other people. And as you go on in life, it finally only functions if some one person's in charge. So, you know, it's not an absolute rule shown by Mrs. Thatcher. Boy, she... so it's not as if men are one way and women are the other. But it's been my observation that women, you know, tend to find more accommodation than men do. And that probably has a, you know, it's not just an arbitrary thing, but it has a some biological or genetic basis. But finding it won't make much difference. It's just it's really how people behave, and I don't think we can change that very much.
You can make a case that males are responsible for a lot of the problems in society. I think most people who study these things come to that conclusion.
I mean, you know, if we, you know, Stalin was a man, Hitler was a man. So you could say all the real evils are due to men. But... you know, we did invent the telephone, the Reaper, the chip, etc. So if men didn't exist, would the human society advanced it? Would it have taken, you know, 100,000 years to happen what we've done in the last 10,000? Could be. So... I like leaders because, you know, generally what I find wrong with most men is they have zero leadership ability, and yet they're technically the leader. So I'm all for any woman who will be a leader, I'm just for more leaders. It's right now, we've sort of demonized leaders. That you really want to find consensus. But I generally find consensus in science, we just never move forward.